choir has prepared a special presentation for you. The title of our choir presentation is He is Alive. After the crucifixion, the disciples sat in the upper room, confused, discouraged, and alone, wondering why. Why did he die? What was the purpose of his death? Why would Jesus, the man they knew to be the Messiah, the very Son of God, be scourged, crucified, and die? Isaiah answered this question 700 years earlier. Listen as he foretold the purpose of Christ's coming. Isaiah 53, verses 3 through 6 reads, He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. Jesus came to give life so we could have life. Jesus fully paid the debt our sin required. He paid the ransom for me. This is why. The title of our first song is entitled, Why.
Why do you come?
chapter 24, verses 1 through 7 read, "Now upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, there came unto the sepulchre, bringing the spices which they had prepared, and certain others with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre. And they entered in, and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spake unto you when he was yet in Galilee, saying, The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, and the third day rise again. The resurrection changed everything. It proved Christ's death had a purpose. It proved Christ's payment was sufficient. We can rejoice our Savior lives, and because he lives, we shall live also." The title of our next song is "He Is Alive." Ye are yet in your sins. Then they also which are fallen asleep in Christ are perished. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. But now is Christ risen from the dead, and become the firstfruits of them that slept. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Only a living Savior can fulfill the promise of everlasting life. Beyond the cross is an empty tomb, and its message that Christ is truly risen means everything. Why is it important? Because death is the result of sin. If Christ never rose again, it means our sin debt was never truly paid. We would not be forgiven. There would be no salvation, for as Isaiah said, by his stripes we are healed. But beyond the cross, the tomb is empty, and God gives the free gift of salvation to all who will receive it by faith. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Verse 18 reads, "He that believeth is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God." Let us praise the Lord that beyond the cross, the tomb is empty. Our final song this morning is entitled "Beyond the Cross."